Hi, my name is Errol Heron, and I'm a graduate student at Urshan Graduate School of Theology in St. Louis, Missouri. Today I would like to talk about the Atonement, and the title of this talk is, Oh, the Wonder of the Cross. The cross is a central theme in the Bible. The cross speaks both to God's redemption and man's disobedience at the same time. There's a duality in the cross, and this is consistent throughout the scripture. From the book of Genesis to Revelation, the tree keeps coming up. In the Garden of Eden, we are told, "And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, Of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it you shall surely die." And at the end of the ages, we are told in Revelation, "Blessed are those who do his commandments, that they may have the right to the tree of life and may enter through the gates into the city." So, between these two statements is recorded the fall of man as well as the redemption of man. In the Garden of Eden, man fell as a result of eating the fruit from the forbidden tree. The tree resulted in a curse and sin. In Deuteronomy, we are told, "Cursed is anyone who is hanged on a tree." God using that which was meant as a condemnation to be the means of salvation. J. Rodman Williams caught this picture and he said, "The atonement is at the heart of the Christian faith." He pointed out that God made up the breach caused by man's disobedience from the garden through the sacrificial death of Jesus Christ on the cross. I should point out that while Adam was to avoid eating from a tree in obedience to God, he disobeyed. But Jesus, on the other hand, he was to go to a tree to hang there in obedience to God, and he obeyed. For as by one man's disobedience many were made sinners, so by the obedience of one shall many be made righteous. David Norris picks up this point when he stated, "When Jesus Christ died on the cross, he offered one sacrifice for sins forever. The cross of Christ is a means by which God took judgment on sin. This judgment was to satisfy his holiness and his righteousness. However, the cross was also the means by which God demonstrated his love and mercy towards mankind. He bridged a gap that was once thought unfathomable. Therefore, I can join with the songwriter and say, down at the cross where my Savior died, down where from cleansing from sin I cried, there to my heart was the blood applied, glory to his name. God bless you, God keep you, and thank you."